So my name is Patricia Odero. I work for Innovations in Healthcare, which is a nonprofit based out of Duke University. We were co-founded in 2001 by Duke University, McKinsey & Company, and the World Economic Forum. In my role as regional director for the Africa office, I lead a team that covers our work across the continent. And primarily our mandate is to identify the most promising global health innovations, whether they're for-profit or non-profit ventures that are looking to scale or that are moving, making that transition from early to growth stage, and support them to scale in their scaling journey. In terms of the innovation adaptation framework, this was really developed out of findings that we had seen. So part of the scaling journey that an innovator makes could either be to move into new markets. And often this move into new markets entails a decision whether to take the current model in its form or to be able to tweak it or adapt it to be able to respond to the needs of that specific market. And so after years of working with different ventures that were looking to adapt their models as they scaled, we were able to gather some insights in terms of what does it take for a venture or an innovator to be able to successfully adapt and scale in a new market. And we were able to combine this into our innovation adaptation framework. Often, it will not be that the innovator will go and set up a new business, but they will approach a local partner and say, we have this model that can be an add-on to your value chain. So how do you adopt something that from a new market into and integrate it into part of your value chain? And so especially in healthcare, this is quite critical because often like the innovations are point innovations. So they address a specific need in the healthcare value chain. So for example, if it's a new point of care diagnostic, that company could be successful, but then they want to now come into a new market and would have to integrate it into, for example, a healthcare delivery chain or different models of their technology being used. So for the adopters, we also have a mindset and a way of thinking. And essentially, this adaptation framework is just that, a way to systematically evaluate whether your scaling and adaptation journey is going well. And then also some markers and milestones that you will be able to test, and an opportunity to also iterate and go back to certain steps and figure out, you know, if something didn't work out, then how can I go back to a previous step? As opposed to previously where we found a lot of innovators and adopters essentially going into this, wide shut and hoping for success. And so we hope that this resource not only goes into the healthcare sector, but other sectors. And we found there's been a lot of appetite as we've presented it beyond, while it was developed with health as a context, we found that there's a lot of interest in renewable energy, in agriculture, in education, to be able to see how ventures that are successful in one market can adopt and adapt their models in new markets. So how do accelerators like Growth Africa take on a resource or a framework like this? We feel that this is a wonderful and versatile tool that can be incorporated into the accelerator curriculum or its offering to the innovators that you're working with. So for some of Growth Africa's alumni, for example, as they look to move from the market that in which they have established into new markets, we believe that the innovation adaptation framework has applicability. Or for example, in the partnerships that Growth Africa has with different ecosystem players, as they are thinking of taking elements that have worked in different markets and partnering with Growth Africa to be able to deliver them in a new market, this framework could also be used internally to assess that adaptation journey and be able to make it more successful and efficient.